Awesome stuff. Love the work that the Vital Foundation are doing. Now, I got very emotionally invested in a particular show this season. Why? Because I was connected to it last year. What a journey, not just for the contestants on Strictly Come Dancing, but for the judges as well. We know him very well, intimately, in fact, because he bared his soul for us on this season of Strictly Come Dancing, one of our judges, undefeated Latin American champion, yeah. Michael Wendig. Oh, awesome to have you here, Mike. Let me shake your hand again.
Nice to see you.
I asked this of everyone who's connected to Strictly. Have you come back down to earth?
It's still kind of, I'm missing my Fridays. Yeah. My Friday was swamped by Strictly. What a great season. We had amazing celebrities. I mean, such a difficult series to judge because there were 8 possible winners.
Yeah.
About that, Michael, like we remember you were the first winner of the very first Strictly Come Dancing in South Africa. Was it different judging at this time? And of course, do you think the right couple won?
Two difficult questions. Okay, the first one is, as a dancer, it's so completely different. You know, you train your celebrity, you go through this journey of ups and downs. It's so difficult. I mean, it really is. It's a task on its own. As a judge, I judge all the time, so for me, it's kind of natural.
Yeah.
The assessment is very easy. The crits are sometimes difficult because you've got a short time to actually relay a message and get a point across.
And you want to be constructive.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And the whole country, the whole nation holds onto every word that you're saying, and don't say and don't, it's crazy.
So, the beauty of life.
And may I just say, these two are just like the cutest things I've ever seen in my life.
Bob got specially dressed up for you today, as you can see.
Oh, thank you. Bob's rolling.
You know, he's got some swag. Now, we have to ask, you know, I was very closely, obviously, attached to one particular team this season,
right.
And so much nonsense, so much was said about the drama between you and Ash. Now, knowing both of you personally, you know, it was laughable at the end of the day, but what was that like, having that kind of drama playing out national TV.
I was kind of surprised when it all happened because for me, I don't look at the celebrities as celebrities. I look at them as dancers.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't get involved personally. I just look at the dancing. It was such a high level of dancing.
Yeah.
So unfortunately for Ashish, every week, and then he was trying so hard. I mean, let's face it. He put in the work and he wanted it.
The transformation was amazing.
But there were so many good dancers. So
it
appeared that I was tough on him, but I am a strict judge. I'm not going to lie about it.
Yeah.
But there is no beef and I'm expecting a dinner invitation at Ashish's house.
So you guys are friends?
Of course, that's how we roll. We're professionals, that's what we do.
Exactly.
Now, of course, like, if there's one thing that I looked out for personally on the show, it was your look every single week.
Oh,
like, forget about the girls, Michael was a
glittering arm sling.
Well, you know what, for me, is that being a fashion designer, I dress myself for everything that I do, and I think image is so important. I think it's the image that you portray, and I love fashion, I love clothing, I love designing. That's my world.
And part of dance as well is the fashion.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's you know, the swag. You've got to have the swag.
Okay, but let's talk about this. It's exciting times for you. You've got a brand new line coming to South Africa.
I know.
Take
isn't
us
that exciting?
It.
Well,
yes, it is.
Last year I launched two specific items. It was called, one's called Mambo, one's called Bolero. And they're both high-end leather jackets. And I think we've got them here to model.
Let's get our models in first.
Where are they? Have a look at that.
This is gorgeous. What's our model wearing now?
Okay, so he's wearing the jacket called Mambo.
Yeah.
And what's really interesting is that the pattern maker is the same gentleman who does Alexander McQueen's stuff. And the factory that makes it does Dolce & Gabbana.
Awesome.
So we really went all out. We're so
spoiled, my friend.
But yeah, you can kind of dress it up. You can dress it down. You can wear it with denim. You can wear it with a bow tie. And if you can unzip that, if you wouldn't mind taking it down a notch. You'll see the leathers in a burgundy.
It's all about the bespoke touches at the end of the day. It's all about
detail. So I went very high end with this. I think it's a hot piece, and it's something that I think will look good in 5 years' time. It's kind of got a vintage kind of feel.
For sure.
And that's what I want my clothing to be, not once off. It's kind of, you can wear it.
I could see a Steve McQueen in that, actually.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's very cool.
Absolutely.
Okay, and then we have the beautiful Miss
Denise. And now we have Denise. And,
gorgeous girl.
She makes that dress. Thank you for making my dress look hot.
You
look amazing. Denise's dress is called Cha-Cha. Yes. Everything's related to a dance name. I thought that's kind of the kick behind it. It's in a gold teal, and I think it's big this season. It's going to be a hot color.
Yeah.
And she certainly does make it look, she makes Cha-Cha look hot.
Oh, she makes everything look gorgeous. That's got sass.
And then you, on the other hand,
dun, dun, dun,
are wearing the third item, and this is called Bolero, and it's a bit more streamlined. It. And what's really there cool about this jacket, if you open it up, you'll see it's kind of silver military.
Yeah. Which I love is really that. Even the inlay on the
and
cups.
And the inside of fear.
You know you're not getting this back, but I hope this is not a prototype because
you guys are so stealing my fashion. What is up?
But Denise, come and join me here for a second because absolutely. You guys have got exciting news as well. That's
we have exciting news. We can't say too much at this stage because it's still under wraps, but there is a hot, hot, hot new TV show coming out. Yeah. And it's with Deneen Naidoo, it's myself, and the fabulous Kanya Bell.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, it's very, it's going to be
what
hot.
A team.
It's a team. We are fierce and we're coming to get you.
I love it. Okay, Talking about fierce. We all saw how amazing the dancers looked like. Their transformation was amazing in terms of their bodies. They lost weight, they toned. Dancing is a great way to lose weight. Would you show us some moves that could help us?
Well, I could certainly try. I mean, I don't need no invitation to come to dance. As long as it's with you.
I am here. I'm the only one that's not dressed. I might as well dance.
She's been building up towards this.
Let's do it.
Okay, yeah. Michael Winting is about to give us a few
a hot,
moves
sexy
here that
Latin
could possibly...
Beats,
you ready for it?
Those hips going, girl.
Woo!
Oh!
Aye! Oh, I love it! Hello!
Of course, Michael known for the fastest spin in the business. That's how you do it!
Woo! Hello!